Beloved, we celebrate the goodness of God in opening our eyes to learn these things. I'm so excited about this word. I keep saying it. Because once we learn it, miracles will increase. Since I started taking the wrong, all I have recorded are miracles and blessings, both financially, relationally, spiritually, the favor of God, the honor of God. I mean, and things come full circle. I talked to somebody today. It's been almost probably 20 years. Some of these things happened and I just took it and never said a word. And all of a sudden, we reconnected today and I'm amazed how things happened. He was thinking I had issues and no, there's nothing. And then I reminded them of the prophetic word God gave and it shocked them because everything had come to pass. So even when you prophesy, you go through things. So if peace is going to prevail, somebody has to take it. Somebody has to humble themselves. The kingdom of God can never run except we start practicing these things. Listen to it again. I'm reading Deuteronomy now, verse 25-35. To me belongeth vengeance. I pray that this will free you from any retaliatory spirit. To me belongeth vengeance and recompense. Their foot shall slide in due time. See, there's a due time. I remember when I discovered God telling Abraham, the sins of the Amorites is not yet full, that this people will sin another 400 years before he will judge them. Wow. I said, that's why you can't be up in arms and expecting God to do something today or tomorrow. No, you retire from it. Receive all the blessings from your suffering and then let that be with him. You can't even handle remembering that you are desiring retaliation or for God to judge for you. That will even make you sick. You see, their foot shall slide in due time. In due time, their foot shall slide. They will lose their footing. Everything will start collapsing when you let God handle it. Whew. He has helped me tremendously in this area. I just let it run. I just let it go and just wait for him. Watch this. For the day of their calamity is at hand. I pray we learn the scriptures. And the things that shall come upon them, make haste. These are spiritual laws. It will come. Peace will come. You will live in peace. You live in rest. And God will handle your issues. God will teach you his ways. God will bless you. God will increase you. God will favor you. Learn the mechanics of peace. Churches. I mean, I heard of a church today. And my God, the things that are going on there. Say, this is not a church. A club is even better. That somebody will walk up and jump the pastor's wife in the middle of service. And they're fighting and rolling on the floor. Hey, Lord have mercy. What kind of church? Huh? And somebody got up and was rebuking the pastor in the middle of his sermon. You should not say this and that and the other. That's how the church of God has degenerated. I just thought that none of these people are saved. If I don't think the Lord Jesus has been that way for some of these people. For the day of their calamity is at hand, and the things that shall come upon them make haste. For the Lord shall judge his people. So you can understand what he's saying. The Lord shall judge his people. He sees better in the dark than in the daytime. You have to understand the process, the magnitude of his judgment, the magnitude of his understanding, omniscience. So you can retire from wearing yourself out. Oh, dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves. I will repay, saith the Lord. For it is written, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. And I'm not quoting it correctly. Yes, avenge, but rather give place unto wrath, for it is written, give place unto wrath. Vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord. You see, let me read a little more from Deuteronomy. For the Lord shall judge his people and repent himself for his servants, when he seeth that their power is gone and there is none shut up or left. You see? He said the Lord will judge his people. And then when he sees that even in the process of judgment, that you're faint and your power is gone, he even in his mercy has a rescue plan. But you're going to go through some rough times. I promise you. I promise you're going to go through some rough times. And in this case, because Israel turned away from God and served other gods, that hurts the Lord. That hurts the Lord tremendously. And that's why after a while, people that are even blessed are having financial problems. When you use your money for anything that hurts the Lord, no, now you're in trouble. Mm-mm. Don't do that. You will mess up. He says, and he shall say, where are their gods, their rock in whom they trusted, which did eat the fat of their sacrifices and drank the wine of their drink offerings? Let them rise up and help you and be your protection. Those of you that trust in friends and be sinning against God, speaking against spiritual authority, and think that you have some kind of fraternity, when your calamity comes, then let your friends help you. We have to bring it to the reality of the New Testament church today. Because people don't understand that God listens to conversations in tents for the children of Israel, or in houses, in our cases, in offices, wherever, in the cars. He listens to everything. Angels take copious notes and carry back thorough reporting on all of us. And then decisions come down. So you have to understand that God told Moses, I will give to them according to everything they're saying in their tents. The people thought that they were protected because no human being heard what they were saying. Everything was recorded. Every idle word men shall speak, he says, we will give account of it. And, you know, I'm guilty of making jokes and saying stuff or whatever. Sometimes I don't remember he said that. They just came to me. You see, so I don't know how God will handle jokes. You know, we don't know. But at least those things are not serious. But watch this. He says, let them rise up and help you and be for your protection. See now that I, even I am he, and there is no God with me. Hallelujah. Whew. In these days of apostasy, God says, I am even I. There is no God with me. I'm the only God. That's what I keep telling you. That thing that has freed me from fear and dread and apprehension. There is no other God. My Father is only God. Nobody else. So I have nothing to fear except him. That's how you come to peace. That's how you stop fighting with people. That's how you stop fearing the devil and being tormented by all his lying prophecies. May God help you come to peace in Jesus' name. Amen. We'll see you tomorrow.